Yeah. So Sin was battling with Nathor Pichu. We saw that. So okay. So welcome back, and today we'll be seeing on market research and product technician. So as you've saw the introduction of the challenge for this week, and also the you've probably gone through the documents. It will be you will be developing, or you will be, you know, I think you understand the concept. So you're going to deal with some products, or you need to have some product in mind in order to bring it to launch and go through all the process. So today's, I am audible, right? If I'm not audible, since I am sharing my screen, you can just open your mic and tell me that if there's any problem or question, or if I'm not audible. So how are we going to do, or how are we going to find out for something or for a product or for, you know, a system that is good, that will fill the market and that will probably be successful and useful and addition for the industry. Okay, so let's see first what market research is and how it is done. So market research, in the first place, it's the process of evaluating the viability of new service or product through research conducted directly with potential customers. So it allows company to define its target market and gets opinion and other feedback from consumers about their interest in a product or service. So generally, it's a process of just evaluating if, for example, it might be we're thinking to have a new service, or we have an existing product that we would want to update it or something. So, but at the end of the day, we have something that we need to give the society in a very fast process that we need to release for the society, okay? But we need to make a research or see if that is going to be successful or not. So let's see just the key takeaways, or what is the point of doing market research. It's companies conduct market research before introducing new products to determine if they're appeal to potential customers, right? And the tools include focus groups like telephone interviews and questionnaires that are used to make some marketing to do the research, okay? There are different methods of taking the research. We're going to see that in the next slide too. And the result of market research informed the final design of the product, and it will determine how it will be positioned in the marketplace. So we're going to see if the product is going to be appealing for the customers, and then we're going to take some steps as it is mentioned here. But not only that, but we're going to make sure that what type of product will it be, or how it will be positioned in the marketplace, how it's going to be seen. It is one of the top products, it is like normal products, or depending on the target, is it going to be known by the youth or the oldest people, things like that. What is the position of the product inside the market? And then market research usually combine the primary information and also data from external sources. Also, we're going to see that. So we can see that in types of market research, as we've mentioned earlier, it is the viability of new product or service, and the result may be used to revise the product design and fine-tune the strategy for introducing it to the public. Okay, you might have some idea in mind, and you want to put that idea to the public. Just we're not going to just put it broadly, right? So it might help us to rework or, you know, redesign the product that we already have in mind. The primary market, there are two types of taking the market research. Those are the primary market research and the secondary one. So as we can understand from the name, the primary research is just directly, you're going to take the research for yourself. So you're going to design the questions, the focus groups, or the people that you're going to ask by yourself. Okay, it's also divided into two. It's exploratory and specific research. When we say exploratory research, it's less structured and functions via open-ended question. Okay, so that people will explain their point of view on that specific question, and you're going to have an information not only that depends on the question, but also you're going to have another insight from the questions. So the question may be posted in a focus group setting, telephones, interview, or questionnaires, results in question or issues that the company needs to address about a product that is that it has underwent development. So in this specific research, delves more deeply into the problems or issues identified in exploratory research. So you're going to, it's kind of providing them with a choice. Okay, what type of product do you use? It is those type of questions that have specific answers, and you can have, or you can gain specific type of view from the questions. How is that done? Isn't it, since it's primary, as I've told you, you're going to decide the questions and things like that. So you can make surveys, interviews, focus groups, observation. So it's observing or seeing the consumer behavior in real world setting in focus group, meaning that there are diverse types of opinions you can collect from small group of people who belongs to specific focus group, okay? And interviews and surveys, yeah, those types of data collecting an information, or those types of researching are the primary researching needed. The other one is, or it's the secondary market research. So all market research is informed by the findings of other research about the needs and wants of consumers, right? So yeah, different market research depend on each other, right? So, and also with most of the market research or most of the research then they are already on the internet. So if we can find them. So in secondary research, you're going to put your aim or what type of information do you want to have, and you're going to go to the pages that are specifically allocated for this type of information, okay? Maybe the government census data or research reports that have been done on this, on the, you know, type of research that you want to meet. So if you are going to refer those types of research, maybe they're going to be, if it is done in a company label, or maybe if it is a body that you believe on, then it's going to be a more accurate and precise data or information that you're going to have. So it's going to, it is done by existing market reports, like previously published reports, online resource, and industry publications, right? This is how it is done. So yeah, we can make the market research in this type of way, in the primary and on the secondary, using the primary and the secondary method. I heard the voice, I will be back. So yeah, the key takeaways or the aim of taking those, doing this market research is just, you know, before introducing the new product, you need to know how that product is going to be wanted or needed by the society or by the target group that you have in mind, okay? Yeah, was that a question? You are too quick. Okay. I will try to be slow. Sorry. Okay. So yeah, well, just summarizing what we have said before and trying to be as slow as possible. Yeah, we've just seen two types of marketing research method, the primary and the secondary one. The primary is done by just doing the research by yourself from the people that you know, or preparing a survey, preparing a question, interviews, and just your observation. It is going to be direct form of collecting the answers or research making the research, okay? In the secondary, we just say that you're going to refer for pages like the government census data or research reports or different types of published papers, and you can have an accurate or precise type of research from those pages, and also maybe not, okay? Yeah, depending on the page, if that is a page that you believe or if it is officially known, then it's going to be a good type of source for your market research source, okay? So yeah, in just summarizing, I was back to the key takeaways and through the questions that you, what do you need to keep in mind while preparing both the primary and the secondary type of market research, or while doing the market research, what you need to put in your mind is at the end of the day, we're trying to have an information about the product that we have, if it is going to succeed, going to the market or going to the, to the market, if it is going to succeed or not. So for that purpose, you need to know if the people are interested about what type of thing they are interested in. Okay, depends. For example, let's say if you are trying to if you're working on the food industry, so you need to know what type of food are recently people's interested about having. So if it is fast food or not, what about the junk food? You can make the research on how is are junk foods being recommended or not. So like if they are not recommended, then it's going to affect your business. So yeah, you can just bring those ideas to the tech world. Okay, what type of tech solutions or tech products are being recommended right now or are being prepared? So yeah, just keep those questions in mind, or first state out the takeaways, the key takeaways that you want to have from the market research that you're going to make, and then go to the questions, both the primary market research and the secondary market research. So saying that, or after finishing that, we're going to go to the product definition. Okay, they have some parts that are going to be aligned, or that are going to be said again here also, but you know, they have different goals. First there is the market research, then next we're going to define the product. So it's the process of detailing what a product will be, okay, including its every detail. So for every aspect of the product, like its features, it is target market, unique selling proposition or USP, and the competitive positioning, or who are the competitors, and what is the, so there's a difference between USP and the value proposition also. We're going to see that. And it involves translating market research insights into specific product attributes and strategies. So at the end, we're going to put or implement the market research that we've done on the first place on the product definition, okay? So while designing the product, or while including the features of the product, we need to merge the idea or the research that we have made on the first step. So product definition, it's essential. Why is it useful? It's essential because it ensures that a product meets the needs and preference of the target market. It helps in differentiating the product from competitors, guiding development efforts, and aligning market strategies with consumer expectations. So if we have just a product in mind, or you know, if we have not defined the product briefly, then what can you say about it? You're not going to have a full information or a direct answer for every question that are going to be raised about your product, okay? So we need to put every features and every aspects, including the target, what type of target customers are you looking for in the market? So what are the components of product definition? The first one is the product vision, which is the overall vision and long-term goal for the product. So you can just generalize what this product is and what is the long-term for the product. You need to make sure, since we're living in a dynamic world, so on the next day or in the next year, how is your product is going to be useful on the or how is it going to align itself with the train that will be coming on the next year, or things like that. Okay, are you thinking to update your product or things like that? So the overall vision, including how is it going to enter the market nowadays, and what about what is its long-term future? And target market, of course, this is also very important, because we cannot target every society. There are some products that can target a very wide amount of or scope of the market, but we need to have a target. Even if it is more than one, we need to have a specific group of consumers that the product is designed for. And then there's the USP, or unique selling proposition, and what makes the product unique and why customers should choose it over competitors. Since any type of industry that you've chosen or that you are going to enter, there is a competitor, right? So you need to, this is also very important, you need to put the unique selling propositions, or what makes your product different. In this case, maybe if you can tell me, there is this value proposition as a whole, right? What is the difference between unique selling proposition and just value proposition? Maybe if there is, probably some of you will have some idea on this. Anyone? Should I repeat the question, or? Yeah, okay, I was just asking. So we were defining, you need to add a unique value proposition for your product, which means what type of specific thing or what type of features does your product have in order to make it better than your competitors, okay? So unique, that is what That is the definition of unique value proposition. And also there is the another term, value proposition. You need to add a value proposition for your product too. It's really a simple order. They are very similar concept. It's just to appreciate the participation. That is why it is just easy. You can even understand it from the name. What is the difference between unique value proposition and just value proposition? Accessibility. So then accessibility of what? And also, yeah, in just through this, am I also quick? No, or is that fine? Okay. Value proposition, are your standout features as your product has over other products? Yeah, exactly. Yeah, that is also, yeah, value proposition. Thank you to Snail Day. We were having editorial session with Snail Day. I was practicing her name, but it seems like I have forgotten. Yeah, it is to Snail Day, I guess. Noski, yeah, you're right. Value proposition, they are your standout features that your product has over all the products. So it is just the overall feature, or you can just say that value proposition, the unique value proposition is subset of the value proposition. Thank you. Just nearly. Back to this, the unique selling proposition, you can just say that you have a unique value proposition. Those are very specific, okay? For example, if we are talking about, again, food delivery, let's just say food delivery, if we are trying to open a new food delivery service, we can just say that this food, our food delivery service will bring your food within 5 minutes lesser than the other companies. This is one of the unique selling proposition. Okay, we can add different unique selling proposition just as the, like on the time, on the other things, and on different types of features. But when you say a value proposition, if anyone say the value proposition is part of the vision or exactly of your business, it is less likely to change as your business grows. Exactly. And the USP is focused on the way, on the why, and now for your customers. Exactly. Yeah, that's the very correct definition of value proposition. When we say unique, the USP, it's, as you can understand from the name, it is supposed to be unique, and it depends on like mentioning every types of features and different types of features that your service is going to be delivering. And that the value proposition is just, it's like a motto that your company will follow or will have or will add on your on that business for a long-term plan. So you need to make sure that you have what makes the product unique and why customers should choose it over competitors, which is you need to add a unique selling proposition while defining your product. And there is the product features and benefits. So the key features of the product and how they benefit the customers, okay? Which means by key features, we just mean that you need to define, even if it is going to be, for example, we took the delivery service as an example. So yeah, just let's continue with that. If it is a food service or delivery service, then you're not going to say that it is a common concept that everyone knows about this type of service. Again, you're not going to say that. You need to define every aspect. We're going to bring the food to your home or to your doorstep, and we're going to make it in a very convincible time duration and things like that. Every aspect need to be, or every features of the product need to be defined or stated. And the competitive analysis, analyzing competitors and understanding their strengths and weakness to position the product effectively. Somehow this is also a very important concept that might need to come before the others, maybe before the product features and before mentioning the product features and the benefits. So there's this other concept called product development, right? So we have a product in mind. So how can we starting from the idea, having the idea of the product in mind to the development? But before that, how is that useful to mention product development in product definition? So product development steps are included in the product definition phase to provide framework for how the defined product will be brought to life, okay? So understanding these steps helps in ensuring that the product definition is actionable and aligned with the practicalities of development and market introduction. So while in the product development, even if it is theoretical, we're trying to prove that there is a method, or in these types of method, or in these types of process and ways, we're going to put the product that we have defined earlier to life. Okay, this is, again, as I have mentioned, it's also going to be theoretical, but it's going to be a proof that the defined product here is going to be brought to life, or it's going to be implemented. So yeah, it's the idea generation first, okay? Again, don't forget that every part of this, or every part that we're discussing, is going to depend on the market research that we've made earlier. So while we do the brainstorming session or the idea generation part, we're going to have an innovate an existing product ideas or strategies to innovate an existing product to the different internal and external source through which a company generates idea for a new product, our customers, distributors, suppliers. So those are one of the methods or like the people that we're going to target while we are about to generate an idea to solve a specific problem. So, but before creating any product, companies evaluate market condition, perform studies, understand the users' wants and needs. So that is what I have mentioned in the earlier part. I have just said that there are some concepts that will be said or that will be mentioned repeatedly on both the product development, maybe on the market research and the product definition. So also we need to make this the research, right? So one of the research is called the SWOT analysis, which is we need to differentiate the framework to evaluate the organization strengths, weakness, opportunities, and traits, okay? So what type of, it's just easy to understand the strengths and the weakness, right? Evaluate market condition, perform studies, understand the user's wants and needs, and then suggest possible solution. So SWOT, it's a very effective technique to discover the weak aspect of the product, as well as to explore where significant opportunities exist. So we can make the SWOT analysis depending on the product and also depending on our company, what is the strengths and the weakness and things like that. But in this specific case, I'm not sure that you're going to be familiar with the weakness and strengths of the company, right? So let's assume that there is the product or the company, the product. So you're going to differentiate the strengths, or as I have mentioned earlier, what is the good aspects or what is the parts that we are going to appreciate from the product, and the weakness. Okay, probably it's going to have some weakness. So what is the weak part or the negative part that is going to not benefit the company, and also that is going to make the product not to be sold or not to be famous. And there's the opportunities and the traits. Okay, the opportunities means what type of opportunities do they exist on, maybe on the country or on your targeted group, and maybe also on the duration. Example, let's say that if it is a time, it's not related, okay, just as an example, if maybe on Corona time, many of us were using TikTok, right? It was the Corona is a disease, we understand that, but it was an opportunity to open different types of platforms like TikTok and other online platforms to be famous and people to be to have fame through it. So yeah, you need to look towards the opportunities on the what type of things are being trained and things like that, and traits. Okay, in traits we might include, for example, there might be a condition that internet will not be working, right? If there is political instability on some part of the country. So those are, you can include those on the part of the traits. So after idea generation, we have the idea screening. What you need to put in mind is that in idea generation, we're going to put everything that comes in mind. I mean, not everything, of course, but you're not going to analysis. You're not going to make the... this part of it works. I mean, this is a very good idea, this is a bad idea, and things like that. You're just going to make, maybe you're going to put 10 or 20 many types of ideas there. And but next, there's the idea screening part, which will assist, which will help you to involve screening and reviewing all of the ideas generated in the first stage and selecting only those with the best probability of success, okay? So many factors are kept in mind while deciding which ideas to accept and which to reject. So these factors include the project advantage to consumers, necessary product innovations, technical viability and feasibility for market, the stage of, so like there are many and different types of things you need to consider while screening those ideas. Maybe here we'll put that almost seven types of our states of states for product development. This is not the case in every situation. Okay, they might be six and they might have different titles, but this is the general format that we can put them. And so even if they have different name and different number, this is probably what they are going to include. These are probably the things that you need to include while on the developing the product. And maybe, yeah, when we say that the idea generation, and you can put every ideas on this tape, and in the other hand, we have just said that we need to make the SWOT analysis, or like the SWOT analysis is one of the effective technique to discover the weak aspect of the product. It doesn't mean that you need to be very careful about the idea generation step. So it's an analysis that will came next, like after the idea generation, or to evaluate the idea that you've generated. Maybe you can also include it on the idea screening part, okay? So it's best performed within the camp, experts from several teams. This is mentioning what type of people do you need to have in order to screen the idea. I think on the challenge, you need to know this as a knowledge, but on your part, you are the one who is going to make the idea screening, and more than the experts, you should be worried about the factors, more of the factors, like their advantage, what type of needs to be considered while screening, taking the idea or leaving the idea. The other one is the concept development and testing, and sometimes it is called literally as a product definition, okay? So which is, after all the ideas pass through the stage idea screening, the ideas are evolved into concepts, which means it's a detailed version of the product idea and contains precise explanation of the idea. We need to have every spec. As we've mentioned, we need to, one of the components here on the component of product definition, it's the product features and benefits, right? So one of the components is the product features and benefits. So here is just putting all the components or all the ideas or the concepts in a detailed version of the product idea and contains precise explanation of the idea. Also, you need to target the audience, the pricing for the product, and the characteristics and advantage of the product that could be valuable for the customers. So generating various product concepts assists the companies in determining how attractive each component is to buyers and selecting the one that will bring them the most value. So there are different types of customers that we're introducing our product to, right? There are those type of customers that are worried about every detail of the product, and there are those who really need to understand about the overall use or the overall effect the product will have. So you need to consider both of the customers while developing your concept, while on the third or the concept development and testing step. And there's the marketing strategy development. So which is, once we have the concept is selected and well validated, it's essential to develop preliminary marketing strategy to launch the product to the market based on the product concept and assess the worth of the product from a business point of view. So the marketing strategy helps in deciding the pricing, the positioning, and the promoting the product. So yeah, it is just on the marketing strategy development. So it's a wide sector or wide idea marketing strategy development, but you need to have, like, in order to market or in order to use your type of product, what type of strategy do we need to follow, okay? In order to have the price to promote it and things like that. Also the business analysis, once the marketing strategy has been developed, it is important to assess the worth of the product from a business point of view. So the assessment of the sales projection, estimate expense, those all are the business-wise equations. I don't think I have those lights. No, you don't have those lights. Yeah, they're not shared yet. They will be shared after the session. Okay. So yeah, on the business analysis, everything is going to be business wise. Okay. Of course, you also on your business analysis, you're going to consider what type of price is going to be fair for the customers to buy. But other than that, it's going to be about the sales, everything about numbers, estimated expense and anticipated profits are included on the business analysis. Also, I can understand that I think the price things and other details, you're going to do them on task two. It might not be so. Yeah, you might probably have a question. How are we going to include the business analysis on the first task if we're not going to do the price creating state, right? So, or we're going to make it a random business analysis. It's about the price that the task two will be, or the detailed price analysis will be for every details and for every for every cost that you're going to use for the product. But on the business analysis, we're going to include what do you think about the general cost in order to manufacture if it is a product, or in order to deploy if it is a software, your project, and how it is sold, just the general, maybe the 3 points. What is the expense? What is the expense of the product to just finish deploying it or finishing the product? And how much is it's going to be sold, and what amount of profit are we expecting at the end of some interval? Okay, just the general aspect of analysis. And then there is the product development, which is in this stage the R&D or engineering department converts the product concept into physical product. So we're finished or we're done with the research and development. So we're going to be going to the physical product, or if it is a software, just doing or implementing, starting or working on the software. So then the market testing and the product launch. Before just launching the product, we're going to test the market on, or if you've seen that, yeah, this part also, it's not going to be included on the, you might not need it for this challenge, but as a concept, you're going to if you see, for example, people with new products, if it is a restaurant, they will have free service, or they will sell a coupon while introducing their restaurant or things like that, right? So before the launching, they will be testing the market or how people are going to respond for the product that I have there. So you might try the free trial, so giving them in free, and you'll see the response they will have for the product, and then you will go to the product launch. So yeah, just this is all about the marketing, the market research and the product definition point. Those are the things that you need to consider. You can find different types of research, but as a general, those are the specific things that you need to focus on while developing your product, and also, while doing the market research and defining your product. So now let's just see if you have any question or things like that, or suggestion. I'm not sure if I understood that emoji well. Peter, is that you had understood the concept, or do you have any question? Or you're just in the middle, confused? I think it was a mistake. Peter, are you there? You have understood it well. So any questions? Other questions, maybe? Okay, yeah. So if we are not going to have any questions, maybe it's going to be the first step. So you're going to choose a product a product that is going to, since it's a 2-week challenge, a product that will, on Accelerate Dynamics, we're to come up with how many products exactly. How many products, Austin? As much as you can, if it is possible, but having just one product, it's going to be, I think just one product will be enough. But if you need to add on that, whatever product that you want have in my perspective, but So like I was about to say, just focus on a product that will help you to do all the analysis and that can go through all the challenges with you, okay? A product that is that will have some a good a product that is going to be good for calculation or that you can understand what type of calculation that you're going to make for it. And based on the market, yeah, just try to be wise and specific while choosing your product. But just I think picking a product that one more than one product is going to be is not going to be easy in my perspective, just yeah. So yeah, are we to choose our own product, like come up with a problem and try to solve it exactly? So try to understand what the company is about for, you know, what Nixara Dynamics is doing. It's just a tech company, so try to come up with a tech solution or a tech product that we are going to that is going to solve a specific problem that you have collected from the market research or from step one. Give us an example of a prospective product. I'm not going to give you an example from my own, but just like TikTok is a solution. If it is no, it's not a solution, it's a problem by itself, but it's a product, I mean. So like every tech related thing, software, an app, Spotify, it's solution. So if it is software wise, also if you can come up with a product, a hardware product that are that you can mention as a like as a tech solutions, if you can consider them like that, you're also free to include a product, a hardware product. But what I recommend is try to, as we have mentioned on the session, we were talking about the target audience, right? So yeah, just start from the target audience. And for that target audience, you can come up different types of the tech solutions. If they are students, if they are just unemployees or even unemployers. So start from the target audience and you can develop different type of the tech solutions. Since you're not supposed to do the product by itself, no, you're just free to go but on the product development step, since you are you know, you are supposed to develop how the product that we have defined to come alive or to be implemented. So yeah, just don't be very ambitious about the product, be realistic. Okay, so Nextra is more okay. Nextra is more on a software company that's a problem for its customers. Any problem as long as it is tech, right? No, there is no problem. Every any type of tech solution or product that is tech related, most probably, I think if I were you, I would have came up with a software product. Since when you say software company or a tech company, it's probably developing software. And yeah, any type of products in daily, right? Any other questions? Okay, interesting. Yeah, it is going to be interesting. Good luck. Okay, if we have no other questions, then I think we can end the session here. You guys, good luck with your tasks and bye. Thank you for being here.